All right, so first thing we got, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 screws up top. Remove all those. If it's never been done before, it's going to be a little hard to do. Take the screwdriver handle. Sometimes they break loose, sometimes they don't. This one hadn't been done before, it's going to be a little bit difficult. There's not really a spot where you can put any leverage on it. Rotate the arm right here. Set this off to the side. Pull the pin out. Get that out of the way. Varnish pretty heavy in there. Get something to save that fuel in. I'll let that soak. You can see our fuel has started to varnish. You might be able to see it. I'm going to go ahead and pull this down, and we're going to throw this in the ultrasonic cleaner. Just so it can clean everything up. Basically, we use a heated ultrasonic cleaner. It's manufactured by Crest is the one we use. It works really well. I have not had a chance yet to try one of the Harbor Freight ones. I really want to. Maybe I can do a video on that in the future. But it's all about the same principle. So it's going to be heated. And I'm using a solution of water and Simple Green is what we use to clean these with. Right now I'm just kind of pulling everything apart. Well, you can see the varnish in there. Not quite wild enough. Hurt my hand earlier. So this is really a chore. Right now, I'm just pulling out the jets. Okay, so these are marked 155. These were our two main jets, and this was a 70. This is, I'm gonna say, is gonna be an idle circuit jet. Let's see, what else do we need to pull? We need to pull this little guy here out in the bottom. It's got a spring-loaded tip in the center, so you're gonna have to push that down with your screwdriver when you go to pull it out. And I'm gonna be using a, what is it, 5/16 snap-on. Flathead. It's got a pretty wide head on it, so I can push that down and turn. It's got like a little check valve made into it. And it's going to have a little washer underneath. I like to put this back on just so I don't lose it. It's pretty nasty down in there. Alright, so our spring's still in place. That little guy there is still in place. That is our mixture screw there, but it's still got a cap on it. We'll find out what we want to do here. I've never taken one of these off before, so this is going to be new to me. Alright, hold on, I'll be right back.
That piece right there, you can You can unscrew it and take it off if you want. There ain't nothing there, I don't think, the way it goes on there.
It looks like it's just a little plunger.
And I'm pretty sure that's all you got to do when you cut them out. You'll hear when you crank them up, you hear it does that till that sun just completely comes off and then quiet down. It goes like,
motherfucker's got a vacuum.
I said, no, I ain't got a vacuum. I stay right there doing this thing.
That's right.
So just give it a little bit of time. And then he said, well, I can hear it now. You hear it slowing down. And that air will bypass the system.
That's right. Well, if you want me to take it off and put it in there, I don't know. I mean, it's up to you. The top side just looked real clean. I was trying to try to get all the gasket off.
Yeah. And most of the time when you have that issue, it's going to be the little...
in the bottom.
The piece that you want to take three screws out of and lift out.
Yep.
With the...
That's right. I don't think it tore.
This right here is what I'd be concerned with, this thing right here being really clean, because a lot of times it'll be shit.
Yeah.
And these little tubes right here will cause you a headache.
Right.
That's your gasket right there.
I believe you're right.
And this is part of the kit. If you need to use that, fine.
Yeah. That looks like it's got that little piece in there, doesn't it?
They usually put two different ones in there. If it didn't tear, I reused the original. If it did tear, it may not be the same pole pattern.
Shit on there. Looks like the same pattern though.
Yeah. Yeah, very well maybe.
And what I figured, I'm gonna just drop this whole thing in there just like that sitting
there
up.
There you go. You heard that.
Never had one of these apart before with this turnkey start situation. Okay, so we got a little O-ring there that seals it off, and then a little plunger. That's off. I'm gonna leave that on there. Leave it just like that. I'm gonna set this in there just like that. Alright, so we got the carburetor out of the heated ultrasonic cleaner, and I'm not sure if you can see that. There you go. So basically you can see there that it almost cleaned everything up. Basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in here with a little Scotch-Brite pad, and I'm going to clean all this up a little bit better and get it ready for reassembly. As you can see, it's cleaning up rather nicely. Okay. This piece here. This is like you pick up in your jets. And very critical, we make sure this is clean. Basically what I do is I hold this up. It's a white background. And I look through the holes. Four holes on either side. And then of course we'll blow air through them. But as long as you can see through them, you should be good to go. I am going to run a jet tool down the ends to make sure that it's clean out here. Looks like we're good. Run some put some compressed air through there. And we should be good to go. Yep, let me get some compressed air. Alright, we're good to go there. Now to the top. Top was already relatively clean. I just put it in there, just kind of knocked some of the stuff off. Maybe there's something you couldn't see, but I wouldn't be concerned with it. What's wrong, bud? Thank you. high, and I'm going to just use some standard bearing grease on the fingers. Very light coat. It's going to make it so it's easier to tear apart in the future if you have to. Do just enough so it changes colors. Can't put the gasket on after the float's already been on there. So you gotta put the gasket on first and then the float. So all your screws on this model are the same length except for one right here. It's a little bit longer. And it's going to go right there. And the rest of them. Just go ahead and put them in their home and get them started. I like to go around the outside edge and alternate. Kind of like you would do with lug nuts. All I'm doing is just getting them started. Well, getting them started and seating them down. really putting any force on it. Going back, no, I made a full revolution. See, this one's loose. I'm gonna go ahead and snug him up. I'm not gonna torque him, just snug him up. Hey, y'all. One more time, just to be sure. This is really a feel thing. Kind of know. Alright, so now that everything's tightened up here, a couple things left to do. Got to put this little guy on here. This is for your turnkey start. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take a little bit of grease right around that O-ring. Sorry. There you go. Right around that O-ring. Just to help it seal a little bit. I think I'm actually gonna clean this up right here. Now, I'm going to take this. You know what? I got to pull the top cap back off. I forgot to put the jets back in. Oh, well. No big deal. I'm sure you don't want to watch me pulling it back apart. Okay, so we got our jets. Basically make sure they're cleaned out, and we're going to have two large jets and a small jet. Both of these are 155, and then this is a 70.